Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Fabela iMac, your channel for video app reviews. My name is Fabian and today I'm going to show you an app review of Dungeon Keeper. Dungeon Keeper is one of those legendary classics. The original game was released in 1997 for PC. The strategy game was created under the direction of cult developer Peter Molyneux, so the expectations for the iOS and Android versions are high. Since many weeks, Dungeon Keeper has been available for testing purposes in some countries. And there was a lot of criticism of the mobile version of Dungeon Keeper. One could also see those critics in the comments of the developer presentation, which was recorded at the Gamescom 2013 in Cologne. You can watch that presentation here in the channel as well. The reason for the critics, instead of bringing the original Dungeon Keeper one-on-one for iOS and Android, EA has decided to modify the gameplay with a freemium concept. This means you can load and play the game for free, but you are confronted with waiting times and in-app purchases. For those of you who have never heard of Dungeon Keeper, I will briefly explain what the game is about. You play on the dark side of the Force. You are a minion of the devilish Horny and have to build a dungeon. What once was a simple cave gets with your help to a dangerous dungeon full of traps and monsters to fend off all attackers, especially those who are interested in your gold. So you are primarily busy with the expansion of your dungeon to build new rooms such as the quarry, the gold mine, the dark library or the training room for your salaried monsters and magicians. The simple button tap, you can switch from the building mode to the campaign where you can perform various tasks. For example, you have to survive an attack against your dungeon or you have to invade another dungeon with your monsters. In addition to the single player mode, there's also a multiplayer mode in which you have to duel with other dungeon keepers. You should always pay special attention to the heart of each dungeon. If the heart of the dungeon is taken, the battle is lost or won, depending on whether you are defending or attacking. Each battle is rewarded with some of the in-app currencies.
We all love the occasional shower in gold, don't we, Keeper?
When the game starts, the cult figure Horny will introduce you into the game. The tutorial is long and you can already guess the complexity of the game. Gold, stones, mana and jewels are used as resources in the game. These currencies can be earned by playing or via in-app purchase. The most important currency in the game are jewels. You can use them to shorten waiting times and they are the most difficult to gain through playing. The greater the time savings, the more jewels you have to use. When the game begins, you receive a good stock of jewels, so your dungeon expands quickly. All of the controls in the game are executed via simple touch gestures.
Your minions have engaged the enemy.
My conclusion. I've really been looking forward to this Dungeon Keeper remake. I loved the PC classics and spent whole nights to expand my dungeons. But somehow the video game world has changed a lot within 17 years. I can't remember that the original was that complex. But maybe I'm just used to more simple games optimized for touchscreens nowadays. When I started Dungeon Keeper on my iPhone, I was annoyed by the lengthy tutorial. It took me some time to get used to the game. I think the title is a bit too ambitious for small touchscreens. There are too many menus, too many subgroups, you have a lot to click here and there, you often enough don't hit the right button and one gets annoyed by the waiting times. Beginners will be overwhelmed quickly by Dungeon Keeper, so you use a lot of jewels at the beginning of the game to skip waiting times. It takes a while to know exactly how things work, the functions of the different rooms, what you have to collect and how to place traps and monsters best. Too bad, you then have already wasted a lot of your jewels. Who can arrange with waiting times will have fun with Dungeon Keeper for iOS and Android. You will get a push notification about the progress of your dungeon. Who wants to play at a stretch will need in-app purchases. The good sides of Dungeon Keeper are the macabre humor and the dark atmosphere, which made it from the original to the mobile version. Dungeon Keeper for mobile is not a bad game, but it didn't convince me really. Have you already played Dungeon Keeper? Then write your opinion to the title into the comments. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.
Keeper, protect your heart. Your heart has been attacked. Dungeon Heart has been destroyed.